want to bring in Senator Dianne Feinstein, the Democratic chairwoman of the Senate Intelligence Committee. Thanks, Senator Feinstein, for joining us. When
You're
you
welcome.
See in a single week, we saw what happened in Canada when a single gunman kills a soldier. We see a hatchet attack of all things on police officers in Queens. Both men seem to have some affinity for, inspired by, somehow violent jihad. You add in a woman in Moore, Oklahoma, who was beheaded by a disgruntled worker who had recently, quote, converted to Islam. You have the attacks in Fort Hood. You have the Boston Marathon bombers who, you know, went online and seemed somewhat inspired by violent jihad. Is this one big problem, or is it separate problems?
Oh, I think it's one big problem. I think one of the problems is that the internet, as well as certain specific Muslim extremists, are really firing up this lone wolf phenomenon. And these attacks and the multiplicity of attacks in 2014 show that their propaganda is having some effect. My view of ISIS is, I think people do not see the evil and the vicious side of it. I don't see think they see the beheadings
of children.
Well, Senator,
they're on. Well, they do see beheadings, though. I mean, they're online shooting soldiers in a ditch. They're online beheading journalists and others, right?
I saw this, but essentially, I mean, for anyone that has any kind of value of a just system, ISIS doesn't make that case. ISIS is essentially a fighting force of 30 to 50,000 people, sophisticated, with commanders, with some heavy weapons, and they are on a march now, and they're going to slay everything in their way.
In the propaganda wars, it does seem that ISIS is quite sophisticated. So let me talk to you about that and how to fight that. But I first want to ask you about these lone wolves, which basically so many of these attacks have been. And by definition, there's no known tie to a terrorist, direct tie to a terrorist organization of any sort. They're kind of one-person cells at this point. What is the defense against that, Senator?
Well, the only defense is intelligence, and that is that you have to ferret it out, you have to be able to watch it, and you have to be able to disrupt them. Now, this is hard to do because it takes technical means, and Americans don't necessarily like technical means.
Right. But more spying is the definition of technical means.
Well, that's right. And this, in the United States, this falls under the jurisdiction of the FBI, not the CIA. And I've been briefed by Director Comey, and I believe the FBI is making every effort to stay on top of this lone wolf phenomenon. I think the White House is cognizant of it and is working very hard to see that we have the ability to be able to find them and stop them.
In the Muslim community, in the peaceful Muslim community, they would tell you in the U.S. that they feel some of the outreach that's being done by the feds, by Homeland, by the Homeland Security Department and others, feels like what the U.S. really wants is for the Muslim community to become their spies within their community in the U.S., and that is off-putting when they do feel targeted, obviously because
of their religion.
How do you bridge that?
Let me say this. The Muslim community is a part of America, and as such, it has all of the protections of any community in America. And one of America's goals has been to integrate an immigrant community into our society and see that they have opportunity, that they're able to be productive, that they're able to live without any kind of harassment. And there are very few countries in the world that actually do that. The United States does it.
Let me ask you, because I know that you lost two deputy sheriffs in Sacramento over the weekend, but we've also seen, and that does not seem, that seems like to be street crime as opposed to anything that's related to terrorism. But do you feel, looking at what we've seen on the internet, some of the appeals from ISIS, that folks in police uniforms, that folks in soldiers' uniforms, whether they're in in Canada or the U.S. are now under an even bigger threat than their jobs would lead you to believe.
I believe that to be true. I believe word has gone out into these communities that a strike target would be somebody in uniform, whether it is police or whether it's military. And I think you're correct in that assessment.
And what's to be done about that?
What's to be done about it is I think the police and military have to be on guard. I think this is very difficult. I think halls of government have to be on guard, the way the parliament in Canada was penetrated. In Canada, you had an armed sergeant at arms who took action and killed the perpetrator. And I think we need to think in some new ways. I don't particularly want to discuss it on television, but one thing's for sure, we are going to protect our institutions of government.
And I cannot let you go, Senator, without asking you about an article I read that posited that Michelle Obama would like to run for the Senate in California and that she has her eye on your seat. 2018, because the feeling is that you may retire at that point. And so I thought I'd get your reaction to that story.
Did you? Well, I have no idea what I'm going to be doing in 2018. That's 4 years from now. And that's one of the nice things of a six-year term. I've served 2 years of my term. And, you know, I'll make a decision in due time. I'm flattered if that should be true. Somehow I do not believe it is true, but I would be flattered if it were.
Senator Dianne Feinstein, I don't know what I'm going to be doing in 2018 either. But
yeah,
I appreciate your being here. Thank you so much for your time.
Oh, you're welcome. Go Giants.
Oh, go Royals.
I got it in.